Tom here with WholeApple and WholeApple TV. Thanks for joining us. Today we have a special product that we're looking at. It is a new Samsung LED monitor for Mac and for PC, of course. So to our Windows brethren and sistren, that means you. But we're looking at it today, of course, for Macintosh. And it is the Samsung LED BX2350 widescreen monitor. And it's so wide I can't even get it on camera. This is a 23-inch LED TV. I keep on saying LED TV, I'm sorry. This is a 23-inch LED monitor or display for Mac or PC. And it's very nice. It's got extended viewing angle, power saving. It's a full 1080p monitor, so it does 1920 by 1080. If I had my druthers, I'd wish it would do 1920 by 1200, but actually, this is actually better for doing things like screen recordings and things like that, because you don't have to mess with the screen resolutions too much or squish anything down to a weird aspect ratio after you've done recording. But a lot of people I know like to use dual monitors. They like a lot of their menuing systems for whatever, whether it's cinema or After Effects or whatever it might be that they're using, they like to use two monitors. And, you know, for the price of one cinema display, nowadays you can get two of these LED TVs. Am I holding this up right? Yes, I am. You can get two of these for the price of one cinema display. So this is something that we're going to be looking at. We're going to be looking at image quality. We're going to be looking at, you know, gamma. The whole 30 billion to 1 contrast ratio thing really doesn't apply anymore because the numbers are so skewed and all over the place. But we will be looking at color depth, we'll be comparing it to a couple other monitors as we go along. But Samsung is very well known for making quality monitors. I have a couple in my studio actually already. The one you see here is a 22-inch. It's an older model, does 1650 by 1080. But it's very nice, and there's nothing wrong with it. I also have a 40-inch Samsung HDTV hooked up as a 1920 by 1080 display for one of my Mac Pros. So I'm definitely a fan of Samsung's. I like their TVs and their monitors very much. So that's good. And we'll go ahead and just take this out real quick and take a look at it. They keep on getting thinner and lighter all the time. When I pulled the box out and pulled it, you know, to my office to get ready to do this video, I was kind of amazed at how light it actually is. This panel, I'd say, weighs probably about 8 pounds. It's probably a little bit heavier than my 17-inch MacBook Pro, which, you know, is probably about 7 pounds, 7.5 pounds. So the screen itself is fairly light. I don't want to drop it here. And take the plastic off the bezel. And you can see it's a very nice widescreen aspect ratio. Very nice bezel. Obligatory Samsung logo. And obligatory Samsung logo, if you didn't hear that. And on the back, we have our two HDMI ports, as well as, let's see here, we have our two HDMI ports, as well as our VGA. And we also have an audio port, which means this has speakers somewhere in it. It's got a nice boomerang type bass to it. And it's got a chrome top, kind of styly. The only thing that I so far is kind of lacking on this that might be in a higher end monitor is some USB ports. But you really can't complain for the price, and for the kind of value that Samsung provides in their monitors, I'm surprised they even put an audio port on it, because, you know, what's the point? Most people who have these kinds of systems don't run audio through these kinds of monitors, so that's kind of almost a waste. I would have rather had seen USB ports on the standard power cord right here, along with the user manual. And we've got a DVI to HDMI cable, which is nice. That's a nice inclusion. So DVI to HDMI right there. And we've got our standard VGA cable, which, you know, most people of course don't use anymore. But it's always nice to have an extra one handy, just in case you might need it. Okay, we simply couldn't wait here. And we just had to show you with the monitor on the stand. So it's got a bit of a play to the angle that you can tilt it. You can tilt it all the way down, kind of keep it off the direct light that might be coming down on top of it, or you can angle it up quite a bit. So just wanted to give you a look at how it looks by itself. And it's pretty slick. I like the look of it very much. And we will be taking a closer look at it on and operational in just a little while. Okay. Okay, we're here with our little handheld ZI-8 camera, and we really don't know what would be better to kind of videotape with. Taping a display is just kind of an odd thing to do, but we wanted to show you some brightness controls here. This is one of our graphics, of course, a lot of color range. It looks kind of nice. The on-screen controls are the kind of Achilles heel of this display, and you can see the colors are changing, the color space is changing a little bit, but I'm just kind of tapping blindly here because this actually, the buttons here, they don't really line up exactly with this where you touch it. So power saving off, we definitely want that. And if we tap here to exit again, see, it's just very difficult to get it up on the screen. Once you get it up, you find where you want to be, and then hopefully you hit over. See, I just hit down, or I just hit up instead of over. And I'm really trying to actually get to where I need to be. And see, now I just hit too far over and it says not available up there. So it's just, it's a real pain in the butt to operate. So we'll go back to auto for this. Now see, I wanted to go back. There we go. And back again. And then I can go over to here and go back to, see, we'll go to, very hard to tap and get to where I want to be. We're on the fastest response time. Color, got our picture, trying to get to color. And you can just see it's really kind of a odd way that it works. So we've got our color. Right now magic color is off, so if we exit back out of here. Anyway, it's fun. So we'll go back to picture. As you can see, this is kind of a problem. So go to picture. We've got our black level set to normal. Response time is fastest. And you know, I'm just having the darndest time hitting the button that I need to hit to get to where I want to go. And magic bright, of course. Now this is group view, so if I can keep this going, I'm gonna pretty much turn it to, if I can get back to it, off. and that's the color that you see there. So we'll try and exit out of here, hopefully. So that's off with the viewing angle, and we'll play a little video here to show you how some motion video works. The 2 millisecond response time of this is very nice. So I'm recording at 60 fields per second here on the progressive camera, but you can see that it's keeping up extremely well with the animation that's on the screen. So, you know, the display is really pretty. It's a very nice, bright, beautiful LED display. The color from edge to edge is fairly consistent. It does exhibit a little ghosting and stuff on the top. It's to be expected with a value monitor, I suppose, but it really isn't that bad. And overall, it's a very nice display. It's actually replacing, for the moment, my 24-inch cinema display hooked up to our MacBook Pro here. So that ought to tell you something. But that's an older 24-inch cinema display, but this is the Samsung BX2350. Fix the controls. That's all I have to say. Thank you.